looks good. Alright guys, so as you saw in that clip, massive L's were taken. However, I didn't want to bore you with some stuff. I kind of just started doing some things off camera, and I got the whole front end disassembled, as you can see. Obviously, that's easy stuff. Like, I didn't want to bore you with that. I had to take off all the accessories. I just kind of took them off the engine and put them over here, zip tied them to this headlight bracket so they're out of the way. Went ahead, got all the other little pulleys off, the tensioner off. I got the crank pulley off. So my next thing right now is I'm gonna actually be getting underneath and taking the oil pan off, because there should be gasket material in the pan if the gallery gasket has failed. So that's gonna be the first thing I'm gonna need to do, because you also need to take off the oil pan in order to get two bolts that hold the timing cover. But besides that, once the oil pan is off, I should be able to take the timing cover off. I know I got to take off the housing here. I got to take off those two grounds. So yeah, let's get into it. All right, guys. So I got the pan off, and what do you know? What do you know? God darn it. But yep, there's the gallery gasket broken in the pan. I'm sure there's more in the timing cover down here somewhere. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead now and just clean up the oil pan and keep moving forward on the next things that we got to do. All right guys, so as you saw, we got the oil pan off. There was pieces of the gasket in there. I just put the pan back on just with two bolts right now, just because I am not going to be taking off the timing cover in this video. I'm actually waiting because our buddy Alejandro, I'm sure you guys have seen him in the videos. I'll insert his Instagram down here. He actually has assembled a hybrid motor, like the 3.5 HR heads along with the 3.7 bottom. So he's very skilled in the sense of doing the whole gallery gasket, removing the timing chain, all that kind of stuff. Whereas me, sadly, I'm not. I have no problem admitting that I do not have that experience. So he's going to actually come up one weekend and we're all going to get it done. And that way we can actually record it and learn from it. And if we ever need to look back and do it again, we will have video proof to see how it's done. So yeah. Also for the people who are probably like, oh, Boza, the oil pressure's low, that motor's probably garbage, etc., etc. False. I did a compression test on the engine, and on every cylinder it was about 240 to 250, the readings on the compression tester. So that's really good, because that's good compression and they were all pretty equal and even. So the motor is definitely healthy. Sadly, it's just this common issue with all VHRs and HRs, the earlier models. So whatever, once we go ahead and get this done, it'll be pretty stout, and I think it'll be ready for boost. It'll be ready for anything that I really want to throw at it. So that's great. Also, another little thing that I learned throughout this whole process was I have a AM oil pressure gauge. So as you can see here, I have it to a sandwich plate, right? Whereas the OEM sensor is right here. I connected a oil pressure tester to where the stock location goes, and the oil pressure was reading lower than it was on the actual AM gauge. So what I'm going to be doing throughout this process is I'm actually going to get a it's like a T that comes off from the stock OEM location that I can go ahead and put my AEM gauge screw that to, so that way I have the correct oil pressure reading exactly from the stock OEM location, because I'm not going to be able to know exact oil pressure if the oil pressure from over here is reading higher than what it is from the stock OEM location. It's not a good time. So definitely want to be able to have the correct readings and go ahead and get that done. But like I said, guys, that'll probably be it for the next video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Yes, it's a major L, but we'll go ahead and get it done, get it fixed up, and hopefully get her back to 100% perfect condition and send it. So yeah, alrighty guys, thank you so much. Like, comment, subscribe. Peace out.